So in segmentation, in the last video, what we have seen is an introduction to segmentation. And a segmentation will consist of each segmentation will be allocated a number, and the lines within them will be addressed by its offset. Offset is nothing but what is the line number that you can, for simple, you can consider the line number as the offset. So a logical address consists of two tuple. That is, one is segment number and another one is the offset within that. So a segment table. So in order to maintain that, in order to do the mapping, the OS maintain a segment table. So what is that segment table? It will consist of, it maps the two dimensional. This is the two dimensional logical address as two dimensions of that. So it maps two dimensional logical address to a one dimensional physical address. That is, if you see that, here you will be having the segment segment number and line within that. That is called, we call it as two dimension. That will be mapped to one dimension, which is nothing but the physical address. So it consists of each table entry. That segment table will consist of two entry. One is base and limit register address. So base contains the starting physical address where the segments reside in memory. Suppose it starts here 0. It starts here 4000 means, this is 4000 is the base of it. If it is 6000, 6000 is the base of this segment, and so on. And so base register consists of the starting physical address where the segments reside in the memory, main memory. And limit is nothing but specify the length of the segment. So for example, this is at 4000th location means, from 4000 to 10 lines are there. 4010 will be the length of the segment. Then the next segment starts at 4011. If it is 50, 4011 plus 50 will be the length of this segment. That is what, that length is said to be the limits. It specifies the length of the segment. So we, this can be called as segment table base register. That is what this base points to the segment table's location memory. Segment table length register, it indicates the number of segments used by a program. So segment number is legal if, when it is legal, if S is, that is, segment number S is less than the STLR. STLR is nothing but the number of segments for that particular process. So here let us consider this view. Subroutine, stack, this is one user, this is a process. So here these segments where it is residing, this is the main memory, this is user point of view. So this is how we see in a C++, whatever it is. So this is how we see in a compiler. So let us consider here 0. This, we have given the name for that. The OS has given the name for this segment. So this is segment 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So if you see that reference, that will be used as an index for this. This is a segment table where here it stores 1400 is the base, which means segment 0 is stored here and starting address. So that is the base. So how many length? It needs 1000. So plus 1000 means it is 2000, up to 2400 way. But the limit only will be given. So 1400 in the second line means 1400 plus 2. So 1402, the second line can be formed. That is how. So that is called offset here. So if you see the segment 1, it is present here. That is given, the 6300 is the base address. And here the limit, that is nothing but 400. So for plus 400, you will have 6700 is the total length of this segment. So likewise, you can see the other things also. So in segment 2, a reference to byte 53. So if you say segment 2, this, a reference to byte 53 of segment 2 is mapped to location. So 4300 plus 53, that is 4353. Segment 3, reference of byte 852. Segment 3 is this. So in this, this is a base. With this, this 852 is added if I want to address that, because it can have a length up to 1100. So 4052, at 4052, you can find the 852th line of inside this segment. In segment 0, if you see this, in segment 0, a reference to byte 122 result in a trap to OS, because its length itself is only 1000. So it cannot, this is more than that. So in this case, it will generate an error.